Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. With this video, I am completing the topic of candidiasis therapy with the tested doses of nystatin obtaining in the course of medicament testing technique. The most extensive group of our patients was, in my opinion, the one that consisted of patients with stomach and duodenum ulcer. For 50 years of observation, we have managed to follow up the dynamic of this disease in 21 patients with fungi-induced ulcer of the stomach and duodenum mucosa. As I mentioned earlier, in our region, a significant number of patients with fungoid pathology of the most various localization is being registered. Complaints of the patient with this pathology were typical and didn't differ from the clinical picture of the gastrointestinal system diseases of other etiology. The patients complained of persistent epigastric pain after meal or soon after meal, hungry pains, heartburns, loss of appetite, and vomiting. The disease tended to seasonal aggravation. The unique difference was that the patients of this group showed constant resistance to the standard therapy for gastric and duodenum ulcers. The patient explained that the therapy resulted in a short-term improvement of the process with subsequent aggravation of the disease. Some patients of this group complained of stomatitis aftosa at the time of their visit or earlier, pain in the intestines as well as tympanism, abdominal distension, and diarrhea. According to the literature data, candidiasis species has often been associated with Helicobacter pylori, and the standard anti-Helicobacter therapy is known to contribute to the increase of incidence of stomach candidiasis. In this regard, it is possible to assume a severe cause of the disease, and the plain antibacterial therapy should be combined with antifungal medications. Some causes of candida-induced ulcer of the stomach and duodenum mucosa are described, thus no Helicobacter pylori are found out in the ulcerous area. Candida species is more often revealed in biopsies of gastroduodenal ulcer in the form of pseudomycelium fungal structure, spores, and budding yeast form of candida species. That reliably confirms the diagnosis of candidiasis. Candida-associated gastric ulcers has been reported in various studies, and according to some researchers, fungal colonization was found in 54% of all gastric and duodenal ulcers. In our study, after the analysis of patient complaints, their medical history, and gastrofibroscopy findings indicating availability of the ulcer in the mucosa of the stomach or duodenum bulb, we always carried out diagnostics by medicament testing technique with application of nozzles of candida species, Helicobacter pylori, and other microorganisms. In cases when candida species were found out by medicament testing technique, we also detected the presence of the fungi in various other sites of the gastrointestinal system, namely in the mouth and in the intestines. In 40% of our patients, candida species fungi only were found, and 60% of our patients had mixed infection with the presence of Helicobacter pylori in the ulcer as well. Gastroscopy demonstrated a submucous tumor-like lesion with a deep central ulceration covered with the thick, whitish exudates in the stomach or duodenum. Medicament testing showed that nystatin doses in the ulcer area were the highest, while in the mass of intestinal lumen the dose was lower. From the very beginning of our work, we came to the conclusion that it is necessary to administer to the patient the maximum tested doses of nystatin. This practice was based on the fact that in course of the therapy, nystatin passes along the entire gastrointestinal tube and renders its effect on the fungi in any part of the intestines. However, we failed to explain the fact of testing the highest doses of nystatin just in the area of ulcer, but not in any other part of the intestines. The fact of testing the highest dose of nystatin just in the area of ulcer, but not in any other parts of the intestines, need further investigation. I must say that tested doses of nystatin in the area of large curvature of the stomach, on the pyloric zone, and in the area of the duodenum bulb The maximum tested dose of the drug was determined precisely at these acupuncture points. In the picture, you can see the acupuncture points I have listed. In addition, we recommended to our patients omeprazole, which is a prompt proton pump inhibitor. Patients receive this drug both during the therapy and subsequently after the treatment for a long period of time in a lower dose. In this wary group of patients, we had to divide the nystatin application into some stages. For example, the nystatin dose was determined to be 30 tablets as a single dose. We divided as at follows. In the first stage, nystatin was recommended in the dose of 9 tablets to be taken 3 times daily during several days. The patients was constantly observed. We assess both subjective complaints of the patients and conducting the monitoring of the dose effect by medicament testing. Our observations have shown that a necessity to decrease nystatin doses occurs within a time frame of 3 to 7 days. On the average, our patients have received nystatin in the dose of 9 tablets per 1 administration for 4 days. Later on, the dose was decreased by titration, with one difference from the earlier recommended pattern. The number of days of the treatment course increased. The dose was gradually reduced, but on the average, each subsequent administration of the decreased nystatin dose was lasted only for 2 days. Thus, in the group of patients with ulcer of the stomach and duodenum caused by Candida species, fungi, the therapy for patients significantly differed both in terms of the therapy and by considerable prolongation of the course of treatment. Since nystatin is a drug with extremely low bioavailability, that is, practically doesn't penetrate the blood when taken orally, it wasn't possible for us to determine the concentration of nystatin in the blood of our patients. It should be said that there are no methods for determining nystatin in the blood of patients in general, since it does not accumulate in the patient's body and its unreacted residues are completely excreted from the patient's body with fecus. On accomplishment of the therapy, our patients did not complain of pains in the epigastric area and heartburn. Their appetite restored, and later on, only in 30% of patients we observed the process aggravation. As a whole, 46% of our patients never more had any complaints associated with the ulcer of the stomach and duodenum. Though the rest of the patients come repeatedly with the complaints of heartburn and loss of appetite, gastrofibroscopy didn't reveal ulcer of the stomach and duodenum in any of our patients. As a rule, their complaints were caused by inflammatory changes in the mucus of the stomach and duodenum bulb of non-candida origin, and we accordingly conducted the relevant therapy. Thus, what is the difference between the therapy of ulcer of the stomach and duodenum caused by candida species and the earlier used therapy of patients with various gastrointestinal pathologies also caused by candida species? Initially, medicament testing of patients of this group indicated higher nystatin doses that could reach 30 tablets as a single dose and even more. It may prolong the therapy because we recommended to start with taking large dose of nystatin for some days, but we never did it for the patients with other forms of gastrointestinal candidiasis. It is necessary to explain that prolongation of the therapy has not rendered an adverse impact on the condition of our patients, and no patient refused for the therapy of the proposed pattern. We didn't observe any adverse effect of nystatin taken in the above state doses. Dear colleagues, I introduce today our approach of therapy of patients with stomach and duodenum ulcers. The information presented in this video may be of interest not only to specialists dealing with the problem of fungal infection, but also to gastroenterologists. The opinion of specialists is very important to me, and I look forward to your opinion. Thank you for your attention. If you liked this video, please like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. For me, it will be the sign that such videos with such a topic are interesting to you. All the best. And see you the next time. Bye.